Assalamualaikum, Pak Sekjen. Pak Kajo sudah ada?
Iya, Bu. Halo.
Ya, Assalamualaikum, Tuhan
Jelas, Bu,
Bapak.
suara saya.
Jelas sekali, Pak. Jelas sekali. Kita masih menunggu Bu Ika-nya kayaknya, Pak, ya, sebentar.
Sudah hadir, Bu.
Assalamualaikum.
Sudah ada, Bu Ika.
Iya.
Apa kabar, Bu Ika?
Alhamdulillah, baik. Mungkin saya mau nge-set dulu ini sebentar ya, nanti gabung
ya,
lagi.
Ya, ya. Oke. Ini saya ini udah ada.
Selamat datang Bu Ika.
Halo.
Jojeng enjing Bapak. Bu, hai.
Bu enjing, Bu Eli. Kelihatannya di ini di Sumedang. Ini di mana ini?
Ini di studio, Pak.
Studio. Iya, bagus lah.
Studio sebelah kayaknya.
Studio sebelah. Hai Bu Ika.
Halo. Assalamualaikum Pak Nana, Kangken, Abdi Ika.
Waalaikumsalam, Bu Ika hatur nuhun. Terus kerasa ya yang pengen uleman di Ibu Kaprodi.
Alhamdulillah, Abdi Ika hatur nuhun terus diundang. Juga tuh susah pakai bahasa Sunda.
Terlalu lama makan salad kayaknya Bu Ika.
Oh iya. Salad kale.
Kayaknya saladnya berkesan banget.
Bu Nadia ada. Bu Nadia, selamat pagi Bu Nadia.
Selamat pagi.
Ini kayak reuni Walenggong. Oh my god.
Ini kayak yang punya cerita khusus Bu Aini.
2017 pada nginep di rumah Bu Ika, Pak, menuju ke Australia tempo hari.
Oh, gitu. Aduh.
Iya.
Yang paling bakso di rumah Bu Ika.
Aduh.
Ngebakso di rumah Bu Ika,
Luis. Ternyata 2017 ya, udah 3 tahun yang lalu.
Iya, udah lama sekali ya, Bu Ika. Sudah jam 9 Bu Ayani, kita mau mulai saja, sudah ada 80 peserta ini.
Siap.
Gimana? Kita mulai aja.
Ya, baik. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Yang terhormat Bapak Dr. Nanang Qasim MAG selaku ketua jurusan di Pendidikan Bahasa, juga yang terhormat Ibu Dr. Nia Kurniawati MPD selaku Ketua Prodi Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris, juga yang saya banggakan dan saya cintai keynote speaker kita kali ini, Ibu Ika Lestari Damayanti PhD, juga yang saya cintai Bapak Sekretaris Jurusan, Bapak Dr. Sajidin, selamat datang. Juga dosen-dosen di lingkungan pendidikan bahasa Inggris UIN Sunan Gunung Jati Bandung, Ibu Nadia, nanti akan bergabung juga Ibu Dian, yang lainnya, selamat datang. Juga seluruh mahasiswa pendidikan bahasa Inggris UIN Sunan Gunung Jati Bandung, selamat datang di webinar public speaking as a one of the practicum of speaking for professional interaction. Pada kesempatan kali ini senang sekali kita bisa bergabung di momen yang sangat langka karena kita kedatangan tamu yang istimewa yaitu Bu Ika Lestari Damayanti untuk di acara webinar praktikum bahasa Inggris ini. Ya, sebelum kita lanjut ke acara inti, baiknya saya persilahkan untuk Ibu Kaprodi, Ibu Dr. Nia Kurniawati untuk memberikan sambutan hangat di pagi ini. Ibu, dipersilahkan.
Terima kasih, Mbak Aini. Ini moderator kita jauh-jauh didatangkan dari Sumedang. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Alhamdulillah. Puji syukur kita panjatkan kehadirat Allah Subhanahu wa taala yang sudah memberi kita kesempatan untuk berkumpul di praktikum. Ini mata kuliahnya Miss Ayani ya, yang difokuskan ke public speaking. Izinkan saya pertama-tama menyapa dan menyampaikan salam kepada Bapak Kajur Pendidikan Bahasa Bapak Dr. Haji Nanang Kosim MAG yang dari semalam maraton, hari ini sudah diminta membuka kembali. Pak Sekjur, Bapak Dr. Haji Sajidin.
Iya, Bu.
Kepada narasumber Ibu Ika Lestari Damayanti, ini terima kasih
sudah
berkenan hadir hari ini dan memberikan ilmu untuk adik-adik mahasiswa di PBI. Kepada para dosen, ada Ibu Dian, ya, Bu Nadia, Pak Ul, kayaknya nanti Bu Predari menyusul. Kepada seluruh mahasiswa semester 3, 5, dan 7. Dan ada alumni yang mungkin juga menyelinap masuk. Terima kasih untuk kehadirannya hari ini. Saya sampaikan salam hangat dari kita semua. Ini kami sedang berada di Prodi pagi ini, Pak Fajur. Sinyal agak tidak terlalu baik, tapi mudah-mudahan tidak ada terputus di tengah jalan. Yang kedua adalah kita ingin menyampaikan ucapan terima kasih secara khusus kepada Ibu Ika yang dikontak dan bersedia meluangkan waktu. Ibu Ika ini orang lama tapi baru gitu ya. Orang lama udah ketemunya lama berkali-kali gitu kan. Tetapi mengundang Bu Ika ke Prodi Bahasa Inggris baru pertama kali ini. Jadi saya sih sebagai penggemar Ibu Ika merasa beruntung Bu Ika bisa hadir hari ini.
Iya.
Mas Sajidin kayaknya juga sangat antusias ya begitu.
Iya.
Mas Sajidin tuh teman sekelas itu waktu.
Iya. Iya. Bapak Ibu, praktikum ini nanti akan dipandu langsung oleh dosen pemilik mata kuliahnya bersama Miss Aini sampai pukul 12 siang. Dan Pak Hajur, Pak Sekjur izin melaporkan sampai hari ini data yang masuk Bu Ika ada 165 peserta, padahal mahasiswanya itu tidak sampai segitu sesungguhnya. Mahasiswa semester 3 yang diwajibkan tidak sampai 100 sebetulnya. Yeah. Jadi kita buka streaming juga di YouTube, barangkali banyak yang ingin menyimak. Ada beberapa dosen juga yang nanti akan ikut belajar dengan Bu Ika, terutama tentang teknik mengajarkan public speaking. Dan 3 jam ke depan Bu Aini akan memandu acara ini. Semoga semuanya berjalan dengan lancar. Bu Ika hatur nuhun. Mungkin itu saja Pak Hajur, Pak Sekjur laporannya. Semoga semuanya lancar. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Terima kasih kepada Ibu Dr. Nia Kurniawati selaku Ketua Prodi Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris UIN Sunan Gunung Jati Bandung. Selanjutnya merupakan welcoming speech, juga pembukaan untuk webinar kali ini. Yang terhormat Bapak Dr. Nanang Kosim MAG, dipersilahkan.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Bismillah, innalhamdulillah, nahmadu wa nasta'inu wa nastaghfiruh, wa na'udhu billahi min syururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina, may yahdihillah fala mudhillalah, wa may yudhlil fala hadiyalah. Asyhadu an la ilaha illallah wa la syarika lah, wa asyhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu alladzi la nabiyya ba'dahu, amma ba'du. Yang saya hormati Sekjur Bapak Dr. Haji Sajidin MPD, yang saya hormati Ketua Prodi Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris Ibu Dr. Nia Kurniawati MPD, yang mulia, yang saya hormati ini narasumber kita hari ini Ibu Ika Lestari Damayanti MA PhD. Terima kasih atas kesediaannya dan kehadirannya untuk berbagi ilmu dengan para dosen, para mahasiswa di Prodi Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris. Yang saya hormati dan saya banggakan host kita hari ini Ibu Dr. Siti Nuraini ya.
Amin.
Terima kasih sudah bersedia juga serta Ibu Bapak dosen Prodi Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris, tidak bisa saya sebutkan satu-satu, serta para mahasiswa semester 5 ya Bu ya. Prodi Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris ya, wajibnya semester 3 yang berbahagia. Semoga kita pada kesempatan hari ini senantiasa Allah berikan kesehatan
Dan tentunya rasa syukur harus kita panjatkan karena kita masih diberikan kesempatan untuk meneruskan sisa usia kita ini untuk menjalankan sisa-sisa kewajiban yang kita jalani. Semoga Allah memberikan kesehatan dan keberkahan kepada kita sekalian. Izinkan saya menyampaikan beberapa hal, terutama sekali lagi ucapan terima kasih kepada Ibu Narasumber serta Ketua Prodi yang telah memfasilitasi para mahasiswa dalam praktikum mata kuliah ini dengan judul Praktikum English for Professional Interaction. Semoga ini bisa memberikan satu bekal bagi para mahasiswa Prodi Pendidikan Bahasa Inggris. Saya mengutip pendapat Ahmad Ali Madkur bahwa berbicara atau kalam atau tahadus atau takbir dalam istilah ini dalam beliau, amaliyatul kalam awit tahadus laisat harokah basitoh tahdus pajatan. Kalau bahasa kita mah bahwa menjadi seorang pembicara yang handal atau memiliki keterampilan berbicara itu tidak bisa tiba-tiba begitu saja, tetapi harus dilatih, harus dibiasakan, dibentuk, harus ada takwin. Oleh karena itu beliau mungkin nanti akan sharing dengan narasumber. Ini saya mengutip dari pendapat Ahmad Ali Madkur. Paling tidak ada empat hal yang harus dilakukan agar dia menjadi seorang pembicara yang handal, seorang yang punya mengajarkan ini kalam, mengajarkan ini dapat berbicara dengan baik. Yang pertama kata gue adalah istisyarah. Itu harus ada respon dulu. Diberikan, didorong, dibiasakan agar dia mampu ayakuna khadijian. Itu bisa saja ini faktor intern eksternal yang mendorong dia untuk bisa tampil berbicara dengan bagus. Ini yang pertama kata beliau. Yang kedua harus ada tazkir. Bagaimana kalau anak sudah ada respon atau dari ini harus ada ketika sudah ada stimulus, pasti responnya dia berpikir untuk mengucapkan yang baik itu seperti apa. Tata bahasa ini mungkin mengabaikan dulu tata bahasa, tapi vocab-nya seperti apa. Ini harus ada tafkir. Bagaimana anak diajak berpikir dengan menghafal, dengan mengulang beberapa mufradat atau vocab. Setelah itu baru yang ketiga siyaghah. Tadi saya katakan takwinul bi'ah. Maka tidak cukup kita memberikan respon, tapi harus ada lingkungan pembentuk yang bisa anak itu terbiasa berbicara dengan bagus. Maka pembiasaan inilah yang harus kita lakukan. Maka tidak cukup kita hanya mengajarkan di kelas saja. Kalau di luar kelas tidak ada lingkungan yang bisa membentuk anak dapat berbicara bahasa Inggris dengan bagus, mungkin hanya teori saja. Maka terkadang harus ada siyaghah atau takwin albiyah at-ta'limiyah. Baru yang terakhir kata beliau adalah nutkun. Itulah dia akan lahirlah dapat mengucapkan, melafalkan dan berbicara dengan bagus. Saya kira ini empat hal ini mudah-mudahan menjadi ini perhatian kita sebagai tenaga pendidik untuk membentuk para mahasiswa kita dapat berbicara bahasa Inggris, dapat berbicara dengan bahasa Arab. Empat hal ini kata Ahmad Ali Madkur yang harus diterapkan kepada anak didik kita. Semoga hari ini yang akan disampaikan oleh Ibu Narasumber, Ibu Ika Lestari Damayanti, PhD ini bisa memberikan pencerahan dan bekal bagi para mahasiswa khususnya, ya terutama bagi para dosen, saya mungkin yang masih mualaf di bahasa Inggris gitu ya, bisa mengikuti dengan bagus. Empat hal ini bisa kita jadikan catatan. Terima kasih sekali lagi Ibu Narasumber yang telah bersedia. Oleh karena itu dengan mengharap ridho Allah Subhanahu wa taala, praktikum mata kuliah ini dengan diberikan judul Praktikum English for Professional Interaction, mari kita buka dengan sama-sama membaca basmalah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Itu saja yang bisa saya sampaikan. Selamat mengikuti, semoga kita mendapatkan sesuatu yang bermanfaat dan insya Allah barokah bagi kita sekalian. Walafu minkum, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih kepada Bapak Ketua Jurusan Pendidikan Bahasa, Bapak Dr. Nanang Kosim, MAG. Well, today we are pleased to welcome Bu Ika Lestari Damayanti, a very special guest from UPI Bandung. So Bu Ika is a senior lecturer in teaching English as a second and foreign language, also teacher educator for pre-service and in-service teacher training, English Department in Universitas Pendidikan Indonesia. Bu Ika also graduated from University of Wollongong, Australia. And then her recent awards, People's Choice Awards in 2016 Asia Pacific 3-Minute Competition. Also 2016 UOW 3-Minute Thesis Competition winner. This is what I really make me really admire her a lot, because she is as the represented the Indonesian woman at that moment, and then defeated the competitors even for Australian. Wow. And then in 2014 as an international postgraduate research scholarship and university postgraduate award, or UPA. Then, and today she will be sharing with us her expert opinion on public speaking, as her really concerned especially about how to speak in front of public as a challenge for the student, especially in UIN Bandung. So I hope Bu Ika can really give the enlightenment for the students. And with that, I ask that you give full attention to Bu Ika and help me in welcoming her to the stage. And also, without any further ado, Bu Ika, please.
Thank you, Bu Nuraini. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, everyone. Is it possible, Bu, and if we have photo session?
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Of course.
I would like everyone to turn on their video, and I want you to grab any drink or food near you, and then just show me your drink, or maybe show me your gorengan if you have.
Okay.
Just like this.
For the video, okay.
Pasta kajur is fasting now. Some of us is doing fasting, Ibu.
Oh.
We have got sanitizer, don't worry.
If you are fasting, then you can grab anything, any object, yes.
We have
nothing. Tapi jangan diminum ya, Pak. Bahaya.
Don't worry.
Okay, so who's going to screenshot our
welcome home?
Yeah. Okay, let's. Ibu Ani, are you ready to take our picture?
Of course.
Yes. Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much. Aduh, yang bawa itu juga ya, ada susu sasetan juga ya. Jadi gimana minumnya dibuka? Okay. Thank you so much for participating in this event. Yeah. Now, before we move on, I'd like to share first my PowerPoint with you. Okay, come on. Yeah. See, I'm not used to with Google Meet. So it just present now, but I cannot find my slide here. Maybe I need to.
It's still. We still can't see the slide, Buika. The slide hasn't appeared yet on screen. Maybe on the process.
This is what I'm worried about. Wait. Usually it's just click present now, and when I click a window.
Window.
It's supposed to be there, right? But why?
Yeah. But it usually takes quite long time. I mean, to
what show on the screen. What if I just send Ibu Nur Aini my slides?
Oh, okay.
Okay. Give it to you. But if I send it to the chat, will it be? So there is no. Hang on.
It's okay.
Okay. We know. No. Why it's not there? Bu Eni, can you give me your email? Yes. Email
on chat, it's okay. WhatsApp web is active.
Okay, I need to turn on my WhatsApp. Okay. Yeah. This is a not so good example, yeah.
That's okay. Actually, yeah, it usually happen in Google Meet.
Yeah. Okay, I already sent it to you, yeah.
Hopefully. WhatsApp.
Yes, in your WhatsApp.
Okay, you're on the process.
Karena jauh ya ke Sumedang, jadi
iya jauh dari Ledang ke Sumedang lumayan. Yep. Okay,
yeah. Finally, yes.
That's the whole process. A lot.
Taking a while.
Yeah. To download it first. Wait a moment. Come on. Usually it's faster. It's really common to wait something special. We need extra effort, right?
Yes, and this can be used as interesting topic as well. Regarding handling the unexpected situation during your public speaking.
Oh yes. Oh my God. Okay, Allahu Akbar, Bismillah. Yep.
Have you received it? Yes.
Yep, Alhamdulillah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to share screen. Wait. Public speaking. Yep. Yeah, opening. Wait.
Technology.
Yo. Is it already appeared?
Yeah, it's loading. I think still black.
Can you see the slide?
No, or it's gone. It's gone.
Gone?
I can't see the slide. Can
everyone see the slide?
No.
No?
No.
No, me.
No, I can't see the slide.
Miss Annie, you can send me the file.
Oh, okay.
Or maybe send me the file.
Yes.
Oh,
Anya, I already sent you the file just now. And see whose signal is strong, probably.
What's wrong?
Anyway, while we are waiting, hopefully that the PowerPoint can come out. Let's see for one more minute. Yes. Yeah, I can see it now. Thank you.
Yay.
Yes. So today's topic will be about head up, speak up, make yourself heard through public speaking. Why head up? Why speak up? Because, you know, in public speaking, there are lots of challenges, including the one that you all have just witnessed. We have prepared, but then things came up out of your control sometimes. Something like the reception of the, or maybe the connection, the internet connections, things like that. And it adds more nervousness. Let alone preparing the presentation itself, but all other stuff can also make us even nervous when starting the your presentation. However, you need to remember, like I'm always telling myself, that the show must go on, no matter what. So you need to have like plan A or plan B. Okay, could you please turn to the next one, Ibu Tani? Yeah. So I'm an English teacher for about 19 years now. And I'm also a presenter in seminars, workshops, and conferences that were held nationally and internationally since 2003. So based on my experiences, I have made some trial and errors in giving up my presentation. And that's what I'm going to share with you all here. Based on my experience, based on my journey as English teacher and also as presenters in those events. Yeah. Okay, next. The agenda for today, I know that it sounds very, very long, like 3 hours. I don't know what we can do with that time, maybe, especially with online meeting like this. It can be very, very tiring. And we can't really move a lot just within this the scope of the camera or the range. And probably you have to stuck on your seat for several hours. And that's not nice, actually, because we can get really tired. Yeah. Now, But anyway, I try to chunk the big time, like 3 hours, into several sections. So where we are now, we are in the beginning of our session, and then I will introduce about the principles, like the things that you need to know how to make your voice heard in public speaking. And then we're going to make a little bit of experiment. I will give you a chance to experiment, to practice by using another tool that I'm also a bit worried in terms of technical problems, but hopefully everything will be fine. And then we're going to have the closing session where you might want to ask questions or make comments. Yeah. Okay. Next one, please. Sure if Google Meet has emoticon or icon like in Zoom. In Zoom, usually we have thumbs up. What kind of icon do we have here for the participants?
I think in Google Meet, I have no idea.
Okay. No idea. Because with big... yes, we do. Dahlia said yes. Ibu Dahlia, can you share with us what kind of thing that we can use, what kind of emoticon we can use in Google Meet? Ibu Dahlia, maybe you can turn on your microphone.
Yes, we can just right click on the chat box and there will be a menu there, emoji menu. Find it.
Just right click. Okay. If you find your emoji there, I cannot find it. Ah, there you go. Okay. Cool. Ah, yes. Yeah. Good, you can choose. Yeah, basically it's in the, yeah. So you have to right click in the message, yeah. In the message. And then you can find emoji. Yes, good. Okay, thank you everyone for giving it a try. Mm-hmm. We're going to use that throughout the session just for me to make sure that you are with me. Because another thing about Google Meet is that once I cannot really see you all while actually when you're communicating. As Pak Nanang mentioned earlier, it's important as well to have response. Yeah, we need to see whether when we talk we have response from our counterpart, our listeners. Okay, so
next
beginning, yeah. Okay, I think everyone can pause for a while from trying the emoji. Okay, we are going to go here to menti.com. I would like you to go to menti.com. So everyone, you can go to your browser and then go to menti.com and you can insert the code. The code is 7968445. For that, I think Ibu Aini, I can,
yeah.
Can I share now my screen? Yeah.
Oh, okay. It needs to be right. Yeah, I stop sharing now. Okay.
Yes, stop for a while and now. Yeah. Are you in menti.com now, guys?
Yes.
Oh.
Yes. When I speak in front of people.
Yeah. Yes, that one. Can you see this? Oh, yeah, we have already got people responded to that one. 79% or, oh, why fail? So for the mistyping, it's supposed to be I feel nothing, I feel good, I feel nervous, not felt. Yeah. When I speak in front of people, I feel nothing. Nice, no, it's nothing. You just need to talk. That's all right. And when I speak in front of people, I feel good because, you know, people can hear me and I really love to get that kind of attention. Or are you the kind of person when you speak in front of people and you get nervous? And
really,
feel nervous, keep going up, yeah. Because, yeah, for me, usually before the presentation, like a night before, I will already feel nervous. And then when I started the presentation, sometimes I feel trembling. I trembled and also get very nervous. I'm afraid that something might go wrong. And I think I kind of predict that kind of thing might happen. And usually it happens. And partly maybe because you think something bad will happen. And then it happened. So actually you just need to try to think positively before your presentation, before you do your public speaking. And I think you also need to anticipate when things went wrong, what you were supposed to do, like you need to keep going and try to be calm and make sure that you have the right support. Just like what I'm having now at the moment, I have everybody in this meeting who are very, very supportive, even when I got some technical problem. Okay, we've got 93% of people feel nervous. So most of us feel nervous when we speak in front of people. Yeah, and actually I'm a kind of anxious. I often feel anxiety when I have to speak in front of people, even though maybe some people said, no, you look confident, but actually my hands usually sweaty and get very cold. If you can touch my hands now, you can see that actually I feel that kind of thing as well. But I try to make myself calm. I need to have a control of myself, and I just need to develop positive thinking when I'm doing my presentation. Okay, let's go to the next question. Can you see the next question? Okay, let's.
Still on the process.
Still on that one. The next question is, I'd like you to think about three words that describe a good public speaker while I'm trying to get the next slide appeared. Yeah. Can you see the next slide now?
Yes, but it's still empty.
Yeah. Because you need, do you have options to write? If you have the code, you can still go to menti.com and then write the code here, 79684.
Describe a good public speaker, okay.
Yes, and you write down three words that describe a good public speaker. Is everybody okay with that? Can you all go to Menti? Good, wow, we have already got three words: confident, attractive, flowing, maybe. Or the, could be like that. Interesting, fluent, fluency, clear explanation, knowledge. Oh, good looking, like Ibu Aini, yeah. Good looking, comfortable, clear explanation, well prepared, yes. Body language. You feel the dominant one is confident, yep. And the next one, I think, the next big thing is interesting, and then fluent and attractive seems to be in the same level. Yes, happy, good intonation. Wow, and it's still going on. Not to saying, yes, okay. That's interesting. Boring, motivating, clear explanation. But still the big words. Being a good public speaker is being confident, and maybe the presentation should be interesting, attractive. Oh, okay, I think it's now settled. See, we see the big word is confident. And that's what we are going to talk about today, how to build our confidence and how to make our presentation interesting. And at the same time, even though you are nervous, you have to make sure that you can calm and happy, comfortable. And it's not only you as speaker who is happy, but also how to make your audience happy as well. Yeah. With your clear explanation and with your appropriate body language, and also with knowledge. Knowledge quite a bit bigger. Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much. Now let's go back to my slide. Yeah, Ibu Aini, could you please share again the slide? Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, so I believe that all of you have participated in Mentimeter, and you see that most of us feel nervous when we have to speak in front of people. So we are all on the same board. So it seems that it's normal, yeah? And then three words that describe a good speaker, as we can see earlier, that good speaker should be confident and then make the presentation or the talk interesting, and also need to be fluent and knowledgeable. So this public speaker needs to show their knowledge, that they know about what they are talking about, so they talk the talk. Yeah. Now, what's the point of public speaking? What do you think? Why do we need to do this? So what is the point of doing public speaking? Because we know that we are so nervous about it, and then we have to be confident while we're actually nervous and things like that. So is it, the point is as long as the talk is done and that's it, or public speaking is trying to make our message across to the audience? Now, I would like you to type in the message in the chat box. I'm going to give you like 30 seconds to type which one. What's the point of public speaking? Getting the talk done or getting the message across? Okay, please do. Go to chat box on the top corner of your screen. Hansa said getting the message across, and Siti Aisa disagree with that. She said getting the talk done doesn't matter as long as you finish the presentation, done. 3 hours, done. Or getting the message across. Most of you said it's getting the message across. Okay. Wow. Yeah. Most of you said getting the message across. Okay, so we can see the pattern now. Yeah. Thank you very much. So we can stop the chat now. Let's go back here to our discussion. So the point of public speaking, it's actually really up to you. You decide why you give the talk. So if you want this, okay, because I have to do my presentation, because my lecturer, because Ibu Dahlia or Ibu Dian asked me to do the presentation, I don't care whether the message can get accepted well by the audience. But the most important thing, I finish the presentation, get things done. That's it. So, right or wrong, it's your call. It's your decision. Which one? Yeah. For me, it can be both. I want to get my talk done, but at the same time, I want my message to be accepted well as well by my audience. Kita ini pakai pertanyaan suruh pilih, padahal jawabannya dua-duanya. This is just another trick how I engage you to my presentation. I just want to check whether you are with me or not. And apparently, most of you are with me. Thank you very much. Okay, the next one, please. So, when we do our public speaking or presentation, you have to try to aim for getting your ideas or thoughts heard by public. So once you have the chance or opportunity to speak in public, to present something, this is a very, very good opportunity to share your brilliant ideas to the world, to the public. Because you have to know that, especially you are as PBI students, yeah, PBI students in UIN, that you have lots of capacity, you have lots of knowledge, and I believe that you also have obligation or responsibility to spread good words to others. So public speaking can be a very good opportunity for you to do that. So just be confident that everyone, that you have great ideas and thoughts. Up to this point, it's okay if you still like doubt, yeah, really, do I have really good ideas? I don't think that people would like to hear my ideas because I'm so introvert, I can't even open my mouth and speak in front of people. But
the first thing you need to do to build up your confidence is that you need to convince yourself first before you convince others that you have brilliant ideas and thoughts. Everybody has brilliant ideas and thoughts that is worth sharing. Once you convince yourself, then you can convince others or persuade others to agree with you. So basically, doing public speaking is just like when you talk to your friends. When you want your friends to accompany you to go to canteen, or when you want to persuade people to eat healthy food, which is hard, for example. But Ibu Siti Nur Aini, for example, I know that in her social media, trying to influence others by sharing good information about a healthy eating, healthy diet, yeah, and this is good. And that can be called as one type of public speaking as well in social media. So she tries to convince others by present very good performance of the food, which is called the healthy one. Maybe to some others, like, it's, oh, that looks good, but I don't think I can eat that. But this is it depends on your strategy in persuade others. And that's what we are going to talk about in these 3 hours as well. And then you need to aim for making a difference for the betterment of your community. So you have your brilliant ideas, convince others to agree with you, and you can make a difference. Yeah. Jadi ini kan seperti melakukan ibadah ya, berpahala juga. So you need to be first confident with yourself, convince yourself that you are good at it, and then you can convince others and persuade others to do what you want them to do and make a difference for the betterment of your community. Yeah. And next one. So another thing that I would like to highlight is that, because you said a good public speaker should be interesting, I don't know if it is beautiful or good looking. What do you mean by that? Because it can be interpreted with many aspects as well, yeah. But good looking, yes, because we don't want to have a public speaker who is sloppy. Kadang-kadang misalnya, saya juga kadang-kadang suka begitu ya, kerudungnya miring-miring atau kerudungnya terlalu ke depan, jadi sampai orang yang ada di depannya juga nggak ngerti, pengen nggak, jadi ini gimana sih ngomongnya gitu ya. So good looking also important, but before those things, you need to make sure first to structure your presentation and your ideas in a systematic way first, and then you can start thinking about your look, and we will be talking about that as well. So what I would like to highlight is that a good public speaker is concerned with their audience interest and confident with their own capacity. So this is what I believe as a good public speaker. So I'm trying to do this whenever I have a chance to present something, just like when Ibu Nia invited me to give a talk here. Right away, I'm thinking about who are the participants. Siapa Bu? These are students in semester 3 and they're trying to learn about this, this, and this. So I'm thinking about your needs, because I want my message heard by you. So how can I make that? I have to know your interest. And I always want to engage with my audience. For example, 2 days or yesterday, Ibu Nia also mentioned, oh, Wika, I'm really sorry that we have to use Google Meet, not Zoom, because one thing or another. And at that time, my confidence level a bit dropping, because Google Meet is not my thing, but this is the challenge. So you have to learn. So I learned, I look up how to use Google Meet, but still I made some terrible things in working with Google Meet. But just believe with your community that they are going to do good things to you. Yeah, so as you can see, we all help each other here. Another thing that we need to establish is to make good rapport with your community. If you share like positive vibe, it can be contagious, yeah? So try to spread this positivity, and then you can get that back to you. Just like what I'm having like you witnessed all in the beginning of this presentation, even though I would after this I would I would evaluate myself and then, oh, it was such a bad beginning of a presentation, and I don't like to start my presentation with technical problem. It means that in the future I need to learn more. It doesn't matter whether it is your thing or not, but you have the capacity to learn. Yeah, so you cannot make any excuses like, oh, Google Meet is not my thing, I don't think I can do the presentation. So it's not a good excuse, because we all have the capacity to learn. And never hesitate to ask. Don't feel that you think that, oh, I'm really stupid if I don't know this. But if you don't know, it's better you ask. I know that you can always ask Mbah Google, but sometimes they can't talk back to us. We sometimes just need real person to explain. Yeah, just like Ibu Dahlia just now. Oh, emoticon ada di sana gitu. And then give example. Oh ya, yeah, jadi percaya betul karena Ibu Dahlia orangnya ada. Saya pernah lihat, so real. Kalau Google kan saya nggak tahu itu siapa, apakah dia robot dan lain sebagainya. Anyway, just be positive with your surroundings. Yeah. So in doing the presentation, if it is face to face, which is the more preferable platform for doing public speaking for me, because I feel close with my audience, I can check whether they understand what I'm trying to say to them, whether they are with me or not. But in the online environment like this, I don't know. For those who are turning off the camera, I don't know what they're doing. I don't know whether they are still listening or they're doing something else. But this is beyond your control as well, because sometimes there are many reasons behind why the audience are not turning on their videos, because they don't like the background. Like my background's this beautiful door. And sometimes because you are very busy and then you have little kids around you and you don't think that you can turn on video while the mess is going on and you don't want the world to see you. So I think that kind of thing as speaker you need to understand, to try to understand that, but think about other ways how to engage with your audience. So I have shared some of the tips with you that you just need to know what kind of affordances or what kind of features that the online platform offered you. For example, in Google Meet you have chat. And then you can always ask your participants to type a word or two words, or just show emoticon in there to show that they are with you. All right, the next one. The next slide, please. Yes. So this is my journey. Probably Ibu Nuraini has already mentioned some of them. And what I would like to highlight here, maybe it's a bit narcissistic of me, but I would like to show you why I can come up with some principles, or I can share some tips with you, because I have been through all of this, and I would like to share this valuable experiences with you all. So my first experience in doing the presentation is because of the class assignment. My lecturer asked me to present a chapter or one concept. Sometimes I did that by myself, or I have to do it together with my colleague or my peer. Ibu Dian Ekawati was my classmate, yeah, in undergraduate program. So we, right, Ibu Dian, we usually work together, for example, to prepare a presentation, and we have to read some difficult articles. We try hard to understand what does it mean before we can put that in a PowerPoint and then present that. So as part of the class assignments, usually the teacher or the lecturer didn't really give very clear guidelines as to what kind of things that I need to put in the assignment. But maybe lecturer here in UIN, they are really explicit with the criteria, like for example, the time, what kind of information you need to put in the presentation or stuff like that. But I don't want just to assume. I would like to invite one of you. Maybe Bu Aini can choose from the participants. I would like to hear your voice. So, have you ever got assignment from your lecturer to do presentation? If yes, what kind of presentation? What kind of subject and how did you do it? Yeah, anyone?
Anyone, can you chat right now on the chat then? I would like to pick up one of you.
Yeah.
Okay, anyone?
I think Bu Aini can just choose anyone.
Okay. What about Shara? Are you there?
Langsung deg-degan kan ini pasti. Aduh, kok aku yang dipanggil?
Rizal, I think. Rizal?
Yes, are you there?
Are you there?
Yes, miss.
Yeah.
Can you hear my voice?
Yes, Rizal ya namanya.
Rizal,
yeah. Okay, Rizal, could you please share your experience whether you have assignment to do presentation in your class from your lecturer or not?
I have a lot of presentation.
Ooh, a lot of presentation. Okay.
I mean, each lesson, we have to make a group and then have a presentation. But the last presentation, I guess, is writing.
Okay. How long did we do the presentation? 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, or it's up to you?
Usually it's around 15 minutes or 10 minutes.
Did the lecturer ask you to do that in, okay, do the presentation in 10 minutes or 15 minutes? Yeah?
Usually we have to, oh my God, I'm nervous. Usually we have to describe the material and yeah, we have to keep in touch with the audience, like do you understand what I mean, like that.
The teacher limit the time, Rizal?
Yeah, but usually it's free. There is no time to present.
There is no time limit. It's true.
Yeah, if we finish, yeah, just finish.
Dosennya ada di sini enggak?
No, I think no.
Saya mendengarnya.
Okay, let's hear one more voice from a gentleman. Yes.
Wait. Wait a moment. Muhammad Bagja Ramadan, are you there? Nothing.
Muhammad Iqbal.
Muhammad Iqbal. Iqbal?
Yes, miss.
Okay.
Okay, just tell your experience when you got assignment from your lecturer to do presentation.
It's a Churchill time.
Okay. Yes. Oh,
Iqbal?
He's gone. Muhammad Rafi. Maybe Muhammad Rafi, are you there?
Rafi. Oh,
Muhammad Rafi has left the meeting once I said.
Oh my God.
Why is this presentation so scary? Because Ibu Ika is asking for you to talk. Rest up with Team Beta, maybe you can.
Alpha, are you there?
Yeah. in my screen, on my screen, I can see Resta Fastutin Bayeta. I think you are...
Okay, Resta.
You are so eager to speak. Yes. Yes.
Okay, Resta. I'm
here. Yeah.
Yes, I have an experience for presentation. But tidak terlalu jauh sama yang dikatakan Rizal because we are classmates.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yes. But in my experience for presentations, I have nervous to convey my idea, and but if we in a group, we can help each other. And in that situation, my nervous tidak terlalu ini gitu. Ya, tidak terlalu puncak gitu nervousnya.
Nah.
But in individual presentation, di situ saya merasa nervous banget gitu.
In virtual presentation. Yeah. Yes,
individual.
Oh, individual presentation. Ya, karena langsung ketahuan on the spot ya kalau salah sendiri gitu. Yeah. Ya. Gak bisa ngomong. Ini tuh apa katanya gitu ya? Aduh, naon itu lupa lagi misalnya. Iya, ya, oke. Yeah, I can understand that. Alright, thank you, Rizal and Resta Fastuti who already shared their experience. Yes, let's get back to the slide again, Ibu Aini.
Okay.
Yeah. And probably, as you can see now, I'm getting calmer than the first one when I started this presentation, because now I get to know you all. I know that you are here and you are all good people. Okay.
Already there? The slide already there or not?
Yes, but it's not on the slideshow.
Wait.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I also started my experience as a presenter for presenting my assignment, yeah? Okay. And usually when I did the presentation as part of class assignment, the lecturer did not really mention explicit criteria. Usually just you have to present chapter one and you finish whatever you finish your presentation. So it's like I have lots of time, but I don't really have guidelines. And then I had another experience. Therefore, I had experience in presenting my paper in national or international seminar. So there where I start to have criteria, guidelines. So like what I need to present, so several stages or several sections. So I have to introduce, usually in a seminar, I have to present my research. So just like a research structure, usually it has the introduction, literature review, and then research methods, findings, and discussion. I also have that kind of structure in my presentation. Even though, for example, my research is quite big, but when I present the research, I'm limited by time. In a seminar, usually the time that is given to presenters around 10 to 15 minutes, and then another 10 minutes for question and answer session. That means I need to start thinking that when I present something, I have to think about not only the topic, what I want to talk about, but also how long, how much time do I have, or how much time do I want to spend for every part of my presentation. And then, so for sometimes I have that kind of experience where I just go to international conferences, usually around 30 minutes for each presentation, including question and answer. And then I had another experience when I have to do a panel session. So a panel session is where one presentation slot in 30 minutes, but there are some speakers. Okay. There are three or four speakers talking at the same time. in that slot, I mean. So it's a bit like presenting your assignment with your friends, but it's just we have a little bit different kind of topic. So here, I had to present my paper in 5 minutes. So usually I had to present in about 15 minutes. That's quite a lot because usually I have a lot of things to say because of my research. But then here I need just to say in 5 minutes. At that time, I didn't know how to do it. How can I just present everything in 5 minutes? But at that time, thanks again to the learning community that I have. So it's very, very important that you all build or establish learning community where you can support each other. And I think here can be considered as learning community. Rizal and my staff, for example, you are in the same class. You can work together. You can always try to practice and ask feedback for each other. Yeah. So at that time, I asked for suggestions, my friends, like how much of my presentation can be cut into 5 minute slots. And then I practice. And here's the key, even though this is not very strict formula, but what I learned is that if you have 5 minutes, so you can break down into even smaller minutes. So 1 minute means that, maaf, karena saya tuh rumah saya kecil, jadi langsung kedengeran dapurnya ada yang masak-masak, maaf ya.
Dapur Bu, ya ampun.
Aduh. Nah ini dia kalau online meeting tuh begini tuh banyak distraction. Okay, so when you think about your presentation, you think about the slides as well. Mm. Yeah. If 5 minutes, if 15 minutes, how many slides? Kadang ada yang dia ngomong 15 menit tapi slides-nya ada sampai 50 slides. Mm. Saya nggak tahu apakah itu semuanya disampaikan atau tidak, atau cuma klik-klik-klik, atau ini mah just in case. Nah, but from 5-minute presentation, I learned that, actually one slide can be delivered for about 3 minutes. And if it is 3 minutes, then how many words do I have to say? So it's another thing that you need to think about. Karena waktu di acara IETFL, ini conference di UK, that was my first, my first experience doing presentation in very short time. Ketika saya pikir dulu, oh kan ini penting, gak apa-apa deh gitu, exit. Tapi dulu ada, jadi sebelum masuk ke acaranya, panitia itu mengadakan gladi resik dulu. So that's quite surprising to me, karena biasanya tinggal masuk-masuk aja ya, dan pas saya ngomongnya kelebihan ya langsung di-cut, no, you can't do that, you have to. Kadang saya juga melihat misalnya di seminar itu, oh maaf, sebentar, masih ada 2 slide lagi, saya belum sampai ke konklusinya. Oh, ini penting loh penelitian saya ini, dia nggak mau mikir juga bahwa orang lain juga memiliki penelitian yang sama pentingnya ya. So, try not to be zolim to other presenters. So if you are given only 5 minutes, just do your presentation in 5 minutes. That is your right. Haknya presenter 5 menit saja. So here's the formula, but not fixed formula. So, but what I usually do is if I have 5 minutes, I straight away thinking about how many slides do I need to have, and then how many words do I have to say. Nah, dalam 1 menit, itu bisa sekitar 150 kata, around 150 words. Mm. Kalau untuk kuliah, tugas kuliah kan dosennya membebaskan, so maybe you don't have to think about this. Just talk as much as you like. But once you are in an event where you are limited by time, you have to respect to that rule. Yeah? And I really love the way you know. Thank you. So you are so good. Yes. So 1 minute means can be about 150 words, ya. Yeah? Bisa dicoba. Tapi mungkin kalau saya mah itu kayaknya kebanyakan atau terlalu sedikit because I'm a fast speaker atau I'm quite slow. Misalnya kalau lagi ngomong cepat. I think I'm a type of person who speaks quite fast. It's not good as well, because again, what is the aim of my public speaking? I want to get my message across. It means I have to make sure my message is delivered clearly. Just like what you said in Mentimeter, in menti.com earlier about a good public speaker, that you need to give clear explanation. And how can you give clear explanation if you speak too fast? And maybe the audience will be left just like, wow, it was great. It's so great that I cannot catch anything because the presenter is so fluent. Jadi malah tengah-tengah karena dia fluent, tapi tadi ngomong apa? Tuing. Karena dia fluent banget gitu. So be careful with that because you want your message to be heard. So you need to plan that. Yep. And then another experience that added my knowledge about how to wrap my presentation in an interesting way is the 3-minute thesis competition. So this kind of competition is popular in Australia and around the globe as well. But first it was established in Queensland. At that time, the founder got inspired by the drought. Jadi kalau di Queensland itu musim panasnya atau ketika musim kemarau itu sangat ekstrim. Jadi memang air itu sulit didapat sehingga ada peraturan dari pemerintah. You only need to take shower for 3 minutes. During the taking shower, so the founder think about, 3 minutes, taking shower, 3 minutes bisa nih. What if I can ask people to present their research in 3 minutes? Nah, jadi beliau kan juga dosen di Queensland University ya. So he challenged his students to present their PhD thesis yang biasanya sampai 100-an ribu kata. Itu gimana caranya yang jelimet, penelitian yang jelimet itu bisa diringkas dan hanya bisa dan bisa dipresentasikan dalam waktu 3 menit, in 3 minutes. So that's when this competition appeared, yeah. And this makes people think hard, including me, I think really hard. But the most difficult one is, how can I make my audience understand what I'm doing when it comes to explaining complicated theories? Karena di competition ini, the audience, nah ini yang tantangan lain dari presentasi-presentasi sebelumnya. So in presenting my assignment for my lecturer, they are from the same they have the same or similar educational background. They are in English language teaching. Just like what I'm doing now, the audience is the audience and I share similar interests and topics about English language, about English language teaching. The national international seminar and then panel session in UK, that's also the same. It's all about English language teaching. But in 3-minute thesis competition, I have to speak in front of people with different kind of background. They are from engineering, they are from medical schools, accountants, but not mostly like from variety of field. So not only English language teaching, maybe some part of the audience is from education. Nah, tantangannya, so how can I explain about systemic functional linguistics, for example? Siapa nih yang udah pernah belajar systemic functional linguistics? How complicated the theory is. And how can I explain that to people who doesn't know about linguistics at all, let alone functional linguistics? So,
Bu Ika, so, yes. The voice is gone at the moment, just a moment, just now.
Yeah, okay. Is it clear now?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right, thank you. Yeah, so in that competition, there are some rules as well. I cannot use any prop. What is meant by prop? I cannot use a media to explain, just like when you are teaching or you do the storytelling or you do speech or whatever. So I can only bring myself and just one slide. And then it makes sense because 3 minutes, you cannot speak a lot of things and one slide is enough. So at that time, I just bring myself and then one slide. And on the slide, I have to make sure that it can help my audience to understand my presentation. And I learned a lot. I prepared a lot for that competition. And I always practice because 3 minutes, I have to make sure if you exceed even only 1 second, you will be disqualified. So I have to be really disciplined on that. And because I won the competition, and then there were people from TEDx, from TED Talk, she watched my performance and she was interested in my talk. And then she emailed me and asked whether I'm interested in presenting my research in TED and TED Talk. It was another big thing that surprised me. It's challenging. I've never been to that. I never think that I would give a speech in that kind of event. So they also have their rules or their criteria. They help me how to do the presentation there. So I had to make rehearsal. Ada gladi resik lagi, panitianya had, and then they watch. So they gave me some feedback on how I use gesture, because I tend to move a lot and then I use the hands like this. So the committee from TED Talk would give suggestion, maybe I can reduce the movement of my hands, something like that, and perhaps gives explanation more on certain concepts. So I'm going to go to that part with you. Yes. So these are my journey in getting the presentation. So types of presentation or doing public speaking, there are many varieties of doing the presentation. It's not only presenting your research paper where you can start with the beginning and then end, getting the talk done, but there are a lot of things also going on there. Yeah, and then some rules in terms of times and the audience, yeah? Okay, next please. And now with the pandemic, it also gave me another challenge, because when I feel that I'm comfortable enough with presenting face to face with my audience, then I have to move to this platform. And it's a bit difficult for me because it means that I need to know the features that the platform offer. And then what is really annoying is that I cannot see you. I cannot see your facial expression, and I won't really actually show my facial expressions as well, but sometimes the internet connection can distract that. So that was my first recipe to make a compelling presentation in English. That was my first online webinar with my bahasa. And then another thing about public speaking, about the type, is that you can make content for YouTube video. Maybe some of you would like, maybe some of you already had TikTok video. TikTok do around a minute, or maybe YouTube, yeah, like the Insta story or things like that. It has, I think that type of public speaking as well in different platform. This one, when I said I love the outdoors, camping and food, that one was created by UOW, the university I was studying. That that they invited me to make a presentation about shopping around Wollongong. Because they know that I'm a Muslim, and maybe I can help in food. Mungkin yang karena kalau Muslim kan suka ada kebutuhan untuk mencari yang halal food. But I need to search some information related to that, and they make a video about that. We are going to watch that in a minute. And then other thing is, okay, one more picture. Bu Aini. Yes, one. Yeah. I was featured by ABC. ABC itu Australian Broadcasting, TV-nya Australia. At that time, I was assigned, or there was actually competition as well in there that about international students and their contribution to the community in Australia. So during my study there in Australia, I also did some voluntary work, where I work in Learning Discovery Center. So I work there without getting paid. And then I work with kids in their learning space. And I also work with Indonesian students with Indonesian students' kids, because there are many students, moms, they have to study, but then sometimes they have classes to attend and nobody look after their kids. So we take turn looking after our kids, and also we create something like preschoolan atau apa ya, kayak daycare, sambil belajar bahasa Indonesianya juga with them, with the kids. So because of that kind of activity, ABC ABC Australia is interested to document what I do. So I also make some public speaking in there, but it's in a different type. And maybe for your generation, doing public speaking online or recorded like this is more relevant, especially in the pandemic era. But it doesn't matter whether you do your presentation face to face or online, there are some principles that we need to take into account. Yeah, so that's what I'm going to share in a moment. Yeah, next please. So here are the principles: what and how to make your voice heard. Yes, next. Kalau misalnya yang udah belajar systemic functional linguistic, I think you are aware of these three variables. It is called as they are called as register variables. But I'm not going to talk about that. But what I would like to so when you are invited to do a presentation, think about these three things. Kalau tadi Pananang ada empat hal. Itu bisa boleh ditambahkan ke sini atau mungkin ini beririsan, you decide, ya. So the first one is the topic. Think about the topic. What is the subject matter that you are going to present? For my presentation now, for example, Ibu Nia asked me to help you to build your confidence in doing public speaking. So I need to think about anything related to public speaking, about the principles that what I thought. And then I also thought about, before I talk about these principles, I also need to know your experience, my audience experience. So it's not only about the topic, think about as well the audience. Who is the audience? Who are the people you are going to talk to? Who are they? What is their background? What are their needs? What are their educational and cultural and social background? What is their interest? Their age, maybe their gender as well. Kadang karena ingin ngabodor misalnya, tapi ternyata ngobrolnya sama orang luar Jawa, ternyata bodoran Sunda tidak berlaku sama orang Kalimantan. Udah istilahnya sudah banyak lengkap ternyata. Ya, seri, karena nggak lucu gitu, because of these cultural differences, ya. Yeah? So you need to be aware of such things as well. And then what is the mode, whether the presentation is face-to-face or is it online? When it is face-to-face, what kind of media, what kind of tools that will help you to deliver your presentation? Whether you have the projector, and you have to think as well, what if the projector doesn't work? Do you have plan B? And then what kind of microphone? Is it that you have to hold your microphone, but if you have to hold it, how are you going to do the gesture? How are you going to use your hands? Or is it a on mic? And then it will be put somewhere in your hijab. How comfortable are you with that kind of thing? And then where are you going to be talking? Is it on the stage? Where? What about the lightings? Kalau untuk presentasi di kelas, biasanya kan ruangan kelas mungkin ya. Kemudian kalau seminar juga biasanya, kalau nggak di hotel, juga di ruang-ruang kelas. But when I did 3-minute thesis competition and also TEDx, they have their particular settings. Untuk competition, karena banyak pesertanya dan banyak audiensnya, itu biasanya di ruang teater, yang tempat duduknya tuh yang kayak ya, kalau nonton bioskop ya. And then there are lots of lights. So I can't really see the audience because of very bright lights. And if you didn't do any rehearsal, it will be really shocking for you. So rehearsal is another thing that you need to take into account. And you might want to check what kind of stage that you are going to have. Ya, dilihat. Bisi, oh ternyata licin. Jangan pakai berarti. Oh, ini kayaknya stage-nya kayu, terus bolong-bolong. Oh, jangan pakai high heel juga, bisa nyelip di situ. Kan juga hal-hal yang tadi masalah ke looking, apa good looking dan beautiful itu juga bisa difikirkan when you look at the, when you are trying to observe the stage, what kind of stage you are going to stand there, ya? Yeah? Okay, so these are the three things that you might want to consider when you prepare your presentation, ya? Yeah? So, topic, audience, and mode. Nah, sekarang boleh nggak invite dulu dari peserta nih ya? Untuk just share with us what you understand about the principles. Jadi tadi tiga principles-nya itu apa sih gitu? Tadi kan ada topik, terus audience, and mode. So what do you know about topic? What do you remember about audience and what you remember about the mode? Silakan. Kalau mulai gitu ada pertanyaan, pasti ada yang has left the meeting. Yes, yeah, don't worry. I won't give you any score. It's just a way for me to engage with you. I would like you. It's actually an evaluation for me whether my message is accepted well or not.
Yeah. Okay. Before I pick one of you, maybe I just give a time. Maybe one of you can, you want as a volunteer? No? Choose one?
Yes, choose one, please.
Raihan, are you there? Suddenly silent.
Suddenly. What about Hamdani? Dani?
Dani is an admin in our
the host Weka.
Oh, okay then. If you are too shy to turn on your mic or video on, okay, I will just invite you to type. Just type one sentence that you remember from the principles that I presented earlier. So what do you remember? Okay, just type in your message in the chat.
Come on, you have to type. Otherwise, I will not give you a score.
Oh, we have already got a response from Beta. Subject matter, yes, the topic. Audience, yeah, Nola also mentioned audience. You have seen the audience background, such as age, presentation structure, area of interest. Yes. Mm. Yeah. It's okay. We must see our audience's background. Yes. Thank you, Faiz. And Nisa, topic presentation structure. Yes, presentation structure. And what is meant by presentation structure? That's what we are going to talk next. Yeah. Yes, anything else? Consists of topic, audience, and modes. Yes, Asri, you are right. The three principles, topic, audience, and mode.
We must know
what. Yeah, we must know who the audience, because we have different humor. Yes. And then in terms of mode, face-to-face, online. And we need to think about educational background as well. Ya, karena nggak mungkin ngomongin systemic functional linguistic sama orang-orang yang nggak belajar linguistik misalnya. Ya. To like a tool like microphone, PowerPoint. Yes, yes, that's right. Anything else? Yeah, it's okay. It's okay that I really appreciate your participation through chats. That's good. And it shows that you have willingness to get out of your comfort zone, because when you feel nervous, because most of you said you are nervous when you have to speak in front of people, but it doesn't mean that you have to be comfortable with that situation. I feel nervous, so it's better for me not to speak up, because the point is you have to control your nervousness. And actually typing up your idea, that is one step towards developing your confidence. Yeah. All right. Let's get back to the slide.
Okay. Wait.
Wait.
It's okay. So maybe ini kalau maybe I'd like to hear from lecturers ya yang masih participating di sini. Anyone, Ibu Bapak, maybe can you please share with us about your students in the class? So do you think it's a common thing, and then is it common thing that the students are reluctant to express their ideas during your class? Ibu Bapak, ini macamnya semua mau ditanyain ya?
That's coming.
Who is speaking? Okay, Ibu Dian. Okay, Ibu Dian Ekawati. Yes.
Yeah, that's a common thing that the students are very reluctant to speak up, especially in front of the class, and also in like in Zoom meeting, they are very reluctant.
What do you usually do, Bu, to invite them to participate in the class if they are reluctant to speak up?
Yeah, just motivate them to speak up, and they should be well prepared before they have the presentation.
Yes, that's right. Well prepared. Preparation is the key to your confidence. You're not confident, it means you are hiding something. But if you prepare, and then you will have some ideas to share. Once you get that, feel free to share with us. Thank you, Ibu Dian. Yes, maybe other Ibu Bapak would like to share?
May I share for a little bit? Wika.
Oh wait, Bu Dahlia is on. Okay, Bu Dahlia.
But I'm so sorry, I cannot put my face on cam.
It's okay.
Actually, I don't ask my students to do presentations too much, because what I experienced is that mostly when they do presentations, they will memorize the materials that they have to present, and I don't really see that they really understand it. And how can they help their friends to understand their material if they themselves, the presenters, don't really understand it? That's why what I usually do is to put them in groups and have the discussions in the classroom.
That's interesting.
And afterwards, one representative from the group will share with the other groups, with the whole class, or we will do it some kind of a jigsaw activity to switch the members, and everyone will have to speak up. Everyone will have to tell the previous group's discussion result with the new group. That's what I usually do.
All right. So during the discussion, Bu, do you observe that the participants or the students all participated in the discussion? They speak up?
Yes, I do. Well, actually, in the discussion, because it's not a speaking subject, so not all of them use Indonesian, and it's fine for me. But when they are presenting, when they are reporting the discussion result with the class, they have to use English.
All right.
But yes, okay. I would observe them.
Yes, good. Thank you. So in a smaller group, the students are willing to speak up. So it doesn't matter whether it's in Bahasa Indonesia or English, but one of the representative, I think that could be the confident one in the group to share, to report the discussion to the class. And it means that that confident students has already got some ideas based on the discussion with other students, yeah?
Yes.
So yeah, he or she is confident enough to speak up. Thank you, Bu Dahlia. Yes, Bu Aini. Go ahead.
Ah, okay, thank you. I just shared my experience on the classroom, since my class is actually a speaking class. So it is quite challenging for me, because I need to make sure that they have enough time for them individually to speak up in the classroom, which is quite hard for me to do so. But then the first thing that I do, yes, like what I like what Budian said, the first thing is motivate them first, and then because I don't know, it's like what speaking lecture is like a motivator for them also. Yeah. Since I cannot separate between speaking and then become motivating to speak. That's two things that I really concerned about. And then yeah, after give them quite, you know, like experiences or make them to be calm and then ready to speak, then after maybe some several presentation, but it's not the kind of presentation, but they express, even they express their feelings, hard for them to say so. And then yeah, but being motivated with by the time they can speak, but not with I saw that I just neglect grammatical and then pronunciation first, but the main point, they express their feeling in English. Yeah. What made me really challenging.
Because talking about feelings, it's actually something which is there, ready. The feeling is there. So you don't really have to think hard. It's not like when you present content. So you can motivate them first by encouraging them to express their feelings, to make them comfortable in your class first. It's because why speaking is so challenging and people get nervous, because we cannot undo what we say, and it's so spontaneous. It's already here and now. It means that we have to speak spontaneously, and when we make mistakes, we cannot undo that. It's not like when we write something, we can undo, we can retype it. And while we are writing, people are not watching us. But when we are speaking, people are looking at us. People are watching us. It's just like when I started this presentation, when I realized that I cannot share my PowerPoint in here, it was actually very, very terrifying moment for me, because I know that lots of eyes will be looking at me, and there will be very awkward silence. And I don't like that at all, because that's not part of my plan. But again, the show must go on. I have to have good control of myself. Anyway, let's move on. So those are the principles, topic, audience, and mode. So whenever we want to present something, because as Ibu Dian mentioned earlier, usually they're not, my students were not well prepared, that's why they're not confident. So preparation is very, very important, ladies and gentlemen. If you want your voice heard, make sure that you have a plan, you prepare. And then what to prepare? Nah, ini yang biasanya suka implicit, nggak ada. But now with these principles, you know the things that you need to prepare before you do your presentation. So if it is assignment form your lecture, what kind of topic, what kind of subject matter? And then what is the structure? You may ask your lecturer, I think, to make it to make the criteria clearer, like what do I need to put in my presentation? Do I need to put definition of a concept, and then after definition I have to put examples, and after examples probably I need to make conclusion? So that is related to structure. And then the audience, you have to think about the audience as well. So if it is your friends, maybe you want to set up your presentation in informal or in a formal way, so you can discuss that with your lecturer as well. But here in my, in our session, in our event this morning, it is, I think, quite formal and informal kind of way. Actually, I prepared this as a formal presentation, but then when I look at the audience, I know that I know some of the people in the in the audience, I feel a bit relaxed, so I can adjust that into a informal way a little bit in certain part of my presentation. Yeah, so it's not a right or wrong kind of thing, or it's not like in the extreme position whether you need to do formal or informal. You can always see the audience and the occasion. But in 3-minute thesis competition, for example, that's formal. I cannot waste my time just to or I just to do humor and then talk about like saying hi, or even I cannot introduce myself because that's not part of the structure of the presentation. Yeah. All right. Next slide, please. So here's the example. In the left side of the screen, that's when I did my 3-minute thesis competition. On the top, that's when I did the Asia Pacific one, and on the bottom where I look so small, but you can see the timer there, 2 minutes 58 seconds. That's when I just started my presentation in 3 minutes. So it's very terrifying at that time because I'm really aware of the time. So once the time hits 3 minutes, I have to stop completely. Yeah. So I have to make sure that I'm just right on time. So there are a lot of things that I need to pay attention to. First is about the time. And then the second one, the lighting. So actually in the audience side, it's quite dark, but on the stage, it's quite bright. So there are lots of lightings, right? Shooting to the center, and it's blinding me actually, it's make me blind. And then people in the front row, if you can see 4 people in front on the left side, so there are the judges, mm-hmm. and they are from different educational background. I have to assure them as well that they understood my research, they understood the complicated theories in my field. Yeah, so that's the challenges in doing the 3-minute thesis competition. But I have rehearsed for so many times. Mm-hmm. When I cook, when I catch the bus, when I do my shopping, I keep on chanting. I memorize my material, this one. Why? Because I need to make sure that I cover the time. So for example, Ibu Dahlia mentioned that if they ask the students to present, sometimes they memorize and doesn't show that they understand. Yeah, so these are the things that we need to consider as well. In 3 minutes, within very short time, it's better to memorize because you cannot bring any notes to your presentation. But even though it is memorizing, but I understand completely what I'm talking about because I need to structure well. I need to have some structure, the beginning and to the end. It's all about my research. But what about in the classroom, for example, for you? I think for memorizing, it's fine as long as you understand what you're talking about. Because when you memorize and you don't understand, the way you say it will be a bit awkward because you need to pay attention to the intonation, the stressing. Yeah. So as a beginner, probably it's fine. Or you can always bring your notes, key points. I think some lecturers will allow you to do that, especially when it comes to the content. But that's what's the benefit of using PowerPoint. If you understand your material that you're going to present, you can actually just put some dot points on your presentation and you can explain that. Mm-hmm. But the problem is with the beginner is that for some students, because I remember my time when I was your age, and I think you are much better now, it's hard to present. I know what I'm going to say, but it's blibbered when I have to say it in English. Yeah? So sometimes I rehearse. So I rehearse, I have my notes, and at first I try to memorize, but when I memorize, when I forget something in the middle, it just ruins everything. Mm. I try to do another thing, not only memorizing, so I make script, yes, just to make the ideas flow, but then I extract that into some dot points, and then I visualize the dot point into a house, let's say. So you can make any kind of analogy that you like. If, for example, The presentation has a beginning, middle, and end. You can think about a house. The beginning means you think about the front yard or the balcony. Mm. And then when you get to the body or to the main points of your presentation, you think about the living room where you can see the chair, the table. So the chair means when you visualize the chair, it means the time for you to make a definition of a concept. And then when you look at the table, and then you have to make some examples, things like that. So you can make the analogy. If your lecturer doesn't allow you to bring any notes, but you don't want to memorize as well because you're afraid that you might be blank in the middle of your presentation, so you can use that kind of analogy. Or anything that you can that can help you to visualize your presentation. Sometimes I think about a fishbone, sometimes I think about mountain. Okay. And I will show you later, yeah, in a minute. Now, the right hand side picture, that was when I did the TED talk. Actually, if you see on the stage, there's a red circle. I was supposed to stand there, but I'm a kind of maybe a kinesthetic kind of person, so I cannot stand still. I'd like to move around. Even now I'm standing because I just can't sit still. So I have to make sure that I move around. It helps me reduce my anxiety. Yeah, so those are the audience also are from, they have different background as well, not only English language teaching. They are from different backgrounds, and some of them also just ordinary people, not lecturer, let's say, something like that. Yeah, okay, next. So after you know the principles, then you have to get the things done to make the preparation, just like what Ibu Dian expected you to do. Yeah, you need to make preparation. So what do we need to do in the preparation? Preparation, so there are around three things again. I like everything come in three. Yeah, comes in three. So first one, outlining and timing. Yeah. Please click. Yes, outlining usually, when we talk about presentation structure, it has beginning, middle, and ending. And you have to think about the beginning, the timing, like how much time do you want to spend in the beginning? Obviously, not too much, because the middle part should take the time more, and then the ending. If you remember in the beginning of my presentation today, I showed you the agenda. So that's the agenda is the structure of my presentation today. And I timed it because 3 hours, oh my God, 3 hours. Ish. What I want to talk about in 3 hours? It's okay, I can talk about so many things, but I want to make sure that you don't fall asleep. I want the message understood, accepted as well. I want you to bring out the principles that I shared with you and the tips and really help you to express your ideas. And I hope that in the future, in the near future, I can hear from Ibu Aini, Ibu Dahlia, Ibu Nia, Ibu Dian, Ibu and Ibu and Bapak. And they told me that their students are more active now in speaking or in class. They are more confident now in speaking up or in expressing their ideas. Yeah? Okay, so after outlining and timing, the next step is to think about ways of engaging the audience. Because as you mentioned earlier in menti.com, you said that a good public speaker should be interesting, attractive. Interesting means that you engage with the audience. The audience find your presentation interesting. So how can we do that? Typically, in the beginning of presentation, you can make an inspiring quote that everybody can relate to, or you can do a quick survey, just like what I did today, when I ask you, so when you speak in front of people, how do you feel? So that's a quick survey. That's trying to break the ice, because I don't know you, and you don't know me, and I want to get closer with you. I want to know you all. So I use a quick survey. Or you can use story. And I use my story as well in this presentation. I talk about my journey in doing the presentation. Or you can also use a rhetorical questions. Just actually rhetorical question, you don't really need to have the answer. Just try to get the audience attention. Maybe the one that I asked you earlier about two questions, getting the talk done or getting the message across. It's not about right or wrong. It's about you participate in my presentation. You engage, you are with me. And then verbal or physical response. Like when I ask you to ask question or to share your experience, I ask you to speak up, so the kind of responses. Or I ask you to make some emoji in the chat box, ask you to write what you know about the principle. So that those are examples of how you engage your audience. And that also can reduce your nervousness. Because you are not alone. You are not the one who do the talking all the time. From 1 to minute berapa tuh, 3 jam tuh berapa menit? I don't know. Yeah. Make sure that everybody get the chance to speak as well. And the last one is, as part of the preparation, practice, practice, practice. Nothing else. That can make you confident. Because I did all of these things. Bad things might happen, just like what happened today when I started the presentation. But again, show must go on. I have to keep my confidence. I have to keep myself motivated as well. I think this, if I don't feel motivated in doing the presentation, how can you? So the first thing is to convince yourself, to motivate yourself. And also, when you practice, you might want to think about the vocal range, whether you want to speak so slowly and so softly like this, or you just want to shout and you want to make highlight some words. Or you want to speak very, very fast, like you mentioned some listing, an inspiring quote, or vertical question, or you can go back to slow pace of your speak. So, that's how you can play around with your presentation. Once you know what you're talking about and think about how you engage the audience, and then you can practice. Practice the vocal range that you have. I know some of you might have very soft voice. Tapi kalau Budian Ekawati, saya tahu suaranya stereo. Sama dengan saya, because you are teachers. Tapi ada juga yang memang udah template-nya itu suaranya lembut gitu ya. Seperti ibu siapa gitu ya, bukan Bu Nuraini pasti. But there are some tips as well. Coba yang suaranya ngerasa lembut, saya nggak akan nyuruh ngomong kok, don't worry. Just give me emoticon in the chat box. I just want to see yang suaranya lembut ya, yang suaranya stereo.
Nadia yang suara lembut itu, tapi nggak ada ya Bu Nadia.
Bu Nadia nggak ada ya. Coba, I wanna see, please send emoji. Kalau misalnya nggak ada, saya nggak akan ngasih tipsnya gimana supaya suaranya keras. Tapi kalau misalnya bagus, kalau udah suaranya besar-besar, berarti saya nggak akan kasih tips. Oh, Utaf Home, Anifa, Sabrina, Yuli, Nola, apa lagi nih, Paula. Kalau suara, ini suaranya pelan ya, berarti ini harus saya kasih tips dong ya. So, oh Muhammad Irfan, really? Itu Nia Kurniawati Bunia. Iya sih, suaranya lembut ya. Nah, yang punya suara lembut, if you want, for example, you want to make sure that you can produce clear, loud voice, is that you have to put your fingers like this. Can everybody show me your fingers? Bu Nuraini bisa di stop dulu nggak?
Okay.
So I can see all the faces. Yes. Okay, ibu bapak, everyone, adik-adik sekalian, show me your. Nggak usah 5 bu, kebanyakan. Bu Nuraini 3 aja. Yes, ibu dia. 3. Yes, just three of your fingers, Aziz. Meskipun suaranya udah keras, nggak apa-apa lah ya buat ngingetin temennya. Okay, 3 fingers. Make sure it's there is no gap between your fingers. Yeah. And then I want you to practice. Kalau mikrofonnya dibuka pasti ramai banget ya. Tapi nggak apa, kita coba. Turn on your microphone. we say good morning together, yeah, everyone. Bu Nuraini, can you leave to make everyone say good morning at the same time?
Okay. No. One. Okay, are you ready? Are you ready?
Yes.
Yes.
Good morning. Now, if your voice is not loud enough, I want you to put tangannya bersih ya. Because you need to put your fingers, three fingers into your mouth. Mungkin saya agak aneh ya dan masih kagok ya tidak. But I learned this from a public speaker trainer in Australia. So I have a friend whose voice is very very soft. Boleh microphone di off lagi. Ya, microphone off. So soal teman saya itu kecil banget. Jadi di ruangan itu soalnya cepat lama karena dia udah nggak bisa lagi gitu. Dia punya asma pula gitu kan. Makin susah suaranya. Nah, jadi dia minta masukkan tiga jari ini. Masukkan gitu dan berlatih. My name is, itu akan kakok kalau suaranya masih kecil. But once you try hard to make your voice clear, you need to really put power. Sampai dia akhirnya bisa ngomong, my name is Clara. But before she said, my name is Clara. Selalu kecil, tapi ketika ada tiga jari di mulutnya itu dia bisa memasukkan.
My name is Clara. Mana indah.
Yes, very good. Well done, Mani. Nah, Mani sudah nyobain ya. Yes. Nah, you can try that at home in front of mirror. Kalau di sini terlalu malu karena kan nggak bisa kontrol wajah gitu ya. Kalau pagi nanti tiba-tiba ada yang screenshot. Jadi lebih baik in your private time, practice that. Put three fingers on your mouth. Make sure your fingers are clean, ya? Yeah? Okay, let's go back to the PowerPoint, Bu. Ini.
Yeah.
By the way, please nod your head if it is a yes. Do you have Google email account? Just nod your head. Okay, good. Because we are going to Flipgrid in a minute. Nah, I'm going to show you as well. Okay, next slide.
Yep.
Yeah, next. Nah, ini oret-oretan saya waktu I prepared my presentation for 3-minute thesis competition. So I make this kind of visualization. Make it visual, yeah? So I have the beginning and then middle and end. So what I'm going to do in the beginning, what I'm going to do in the middle part and the ending. So I have my plan. I plan it. So before I make the script, which if you still remember, sambil diketik ya, tadi kalau 1 menit itu berapa words?
150.
buat mahasiswanya buah ini. Yes, 150. Kalau 3 minutes, how many slides? Type in the comments. Type in the chat. How many slides can we deliver in 3 minutes? One slide, Mbak Eta. Good job. You pay attention. Rizal, yes. Thank you. Yeah. Tapi itu juga bukan aturan yang ini ya. Cuma kalau di 3 menit itu kita juga membawakannya tenang, nggak terburu-buru dan semua bisa dieksplor. But it depends on your purpose of the presentation. Tapi kalau mau nunjukin animasi dan tiap slide harus diketik di klik dan cepat, it's different method. Tapi kalau in a type of presentation just like what I'm doing now, typically one slide for 3 minutes ya. Yeah? Jadi berapa words atau ya? Kalau 1 menit 150, how many words in 3 minutes? Just do the math. Yes, Anissa, thank you, Nola. Mitri, Utaf, 450, around that, yeah? So you don't have to speak in a hurry. Yes, next slide please, Ibu Aini. Okay, bisa diputar nggak ya di Bu Aini di situ? I would like you to, I'm going to share with you this 1 minute clip. I want you to pay attention how I engage the audience, yeah? So this is a clip from my TED Talk in Wollongong. This is, so my talk at that time was about storytelling. I tried to convince the audience that storytelling is a good way to help us, to help students in EFL context to learn English. So this is the part where I'm telling a story to the audience. Yeah, go ahead, Bu Aini, please.
To eat her one day. Kancil the mouse deer wanted to get across to the other side of the river. But as you predict, there were so many crocodiles who were hungry and wanted to eat her. She said, "Hey, crocodiles, I know that you are all hungry and want to eat me. But look at you. There are so many of you and only one me. But don't worry. I will make sure that each and every one of you will get equal share of my body. I will count. I will jump on you, but don't eat me yet. And I will say what you'll get. And you will say it with me. Are you ready, crocodile? Yes? I cannot hear you, crocodile. Are you ready? Good. Satu. Okay. Kepala. Dua. Tangan. Tiga. Kaki. And on, and on, and on.
Yeah, thank you. Now, you have just watched this very short clip of mine trying to engage with the audience who don't speak Bahasa Indonesia. Obviously, they are Australians, they speak English. So, what did I do to engage them? Anyone would like to make comments? Boleh dibuka mikrofonnya? Boleh pakai Bahasa Indonesia if you are not really confident if you say it in English? Ayo dong, udah makin siang, harusnya lebih semangat. Ya, mau dimana? Asri Aziza. Yes.
Try to get the audience's response by asking them.
Okay, yes. Asking them. Thank you, Asri, by asking them. Ada lagi nggak selain asking them? Yang lain, silahkan tambahkan lagi. Yes, itu kan nggak apa-apa. Asri udah ngejawab, masih baik-baik aja.
Doing a body language.
Body language, yes, yes. What did you notice? How did I use my body language, Nola? Can you say some more?
About when that? You said kepala, you touch your head.
And yes, that's right. Yep, yep. Anything else? Maybe you want to comment on the voice range, still about body language as well. Yang lain?
Miss, can I answer it?
Of course, Rinita, you're very welcome.
You tried to engage with your audience by making eye contact and also body language.
Yes.
And yeah, asking them with various question so they can answer your question and understanding
and
you.
Participated, yeah? Yes, yes. That's right, Rinita. Thank you very much. I made eye contact. And to be honest, at that time I was very, very nervous. I was afraid that nobody would do what I said to them. Gimana kalau mereka nggak mau participate? Gimana kalau mereka diem aja? Gimana kalau, oh, pokoknya semua hal-hal yang buruk. Kan jadi mati gaya ya, saya udah invite. And then, when I point at them, I just try to make them into my story. That I consider them as crocodile. Actually, I'm trying to control my anxiety as well. So pointing them out as part of my performance as well. But actually, deep down, it's about controlling my nervousness. And that's when I make eye contact with them. You, and you, all crocodile. When maybe the crocodile or the audience are not really sure as well whether they have to join in with me or not. So at first, they just respond in a very soft voice. So when I ask them, I cannot hear you, crocodile. So when I change my voice tone, it means that I really want to emphasize. I emphasize them to respond to me. So you don't really have to talk much. You can just play around with the intonation. So go back to Ibu Dahlia's comment earlier that students tend to memorize and they don't seem understand. So it's very important that you know what you're talking about, because when you memorize, it will make sense, because you can use appropriate voice range and intonation and appropriate body language as well. Yeah. All right, the next one.
I wanted to eat her one day. Until the mouse dear wanted to get across to the other side of the
room. Click on the yellow part and on the purple part. Terus klik lagi biasanya.
Yep.
Go. Yeah. Okay, next we have done this. Yeah, I have another example. This one, this is a bit long, 3 minutes, but I would like you to pay attention the same thing. What kind of topic? How do I engage with the audience? And what kind of mode? What kind of modalities? What kind of tools that I use here? How do I engage? Is it different from the way I do it in face-to-face performance? I think for this one, I can just share from my my computer here, Bu Aini. Maybe you can.
Yeah, okay.
And then I will share.
Done.
Okay, thank you. Yes, are you ready, guys? So what I would like you to pay attention to is this one.
Hello, my name is Ika. I love you.
Is it clear or not? It's not that clear, isn't it?
The voice.
The voice is not clear. But there's a subtitle like this. Wait. Yeah. Hang on. Hey.
And food. When I first arrived in Australia, the thing that was hugely different was the food. There's nothing better than making and eating the foods you love. So, from wherever you come from, you are invited for buying your favorite food in Wollongong. Here, most people go to large supermarkets to buy their food. The main supermarket chains are Coles, Woolworths, and IGA. And the good thing is, it is on campus. Aldi supermarkets have a low variety of brands, but they have many cheaper options. There are also plenty of international grocery stores throughout Wollongong that specialize in products from Asia, Europe, Persia, and halal products. Dongfeng, it is one of my favorite Asian grocers because you can suggest a product that you would like them to stock on their shelves. If you move into a private rental accommodation, you will need to buy lots of things apart from your food. And maybe you need some clothes or other items that did not quite fit into your suitcase. Definitely go to the UOW Goodwill Hunting event at the beginning of the section for heaps of free stuff. I got my things for my kitchen, my bedroom, and other furniture. There are also online pages such as the UOW Students Buy and sell Facebook page or Gumtree for second-hand items that people are selling or giving away for free. You You know what? I bought a kayak. Secondhand clothing, toys, books, furniture, and other things are sold in stores called op shops. There are lots of op shops such as Salvos, Vinnies, and Red Cross. Australians often put things out beside the road, and this means it's going to be thrown away, and they are free to pay. Yeah, and you can find some good things there too. If you like to buy things new, at the More Budget Shop for household items and clothes are Kmart, BW, Best & Last, and Target. It's a good idea to bring your own bags, because at Top Shop, you need to pay for plastic bags. Make sure you jump online to check out what shops are close to where you will be staying and the operating hours, as these may be different to what you are used to. And thankfully, the amazing free bus services has bus stops near most of these places, so it is super easy to access them. I hope this was helpful. Don't be scared to ask people when you arrive where the best bargains are.
Yeah. Okay, so that's the 3-minute video on tips how to go shopping in Wollongong. Now, for that kind of presentation, because that is recorded one, so what do you notice? How do I try to engage with the audience? Maybe, you know, the topics about shopping, and then what are the ways I engage with my audience that I cannot see, obviously, and then what kind of mode that I use as well. Okay, anyone, please just turn on your microphone and then speak up.
Maybe, ma'am.
Yes.
Waving at the camera. Yeah, waving at the camera, smiling at the camera.
Yes, smiling constantly and waving. If you see that, so the director of that video also told me that in social media you need to smile a lot, extremely a lot, while you speak. Even I cannot speak without smiling. So I have been told to constantly smile while I speak. It's a bit tiring, and waving all the time, because that way make the audience want to see me. Yeah, good one, Fadila. What else? What other things? Don't worry, there's no right or wrong. Yes, Nola.
You show the place, the store that audience can see the store too, that can,
yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I show around the shops, not only the picture or the snapshot footage, but also I went there, because that's the video, yeah, because it is recorded, you can edit that as well. Yeah, that's right. Anything else? Do you think I memorize what I say? What do you think about that? Yes, Nola? Or others?
I saw that you are just improve what you're gonna talk in your mind.
Yeah, it's like I'm just talking through spontaneously. Yeah. Actually, I memorize, and also there's a prompt in front of me so I can read as well. But it looks natural because I rehearse what I'm going to say, and I use the intonation and vocal range as well. So it's okay if you want to memorize, as long as you know what you're talking about, so you can make appropriate intonation. Because that's not my language. And again, because in that video I have to speak for 3 minutes, no more than that, so I'm limited by time as well, and I have to make sure what I say match with the footage as well, like when I'm talking about the shops and I'm talking about the things that I need to buy, things like that. So it's rehearsed, so it's very important no matter what. Jadi mungkin youtuber yang successful itu juga they prepare, they make their storyboard first, and then they rehearse before they actually show their video to or upload it in YouTube. they make preparation as well. They think about the audience, target audience-nya siapa sih gitu. Yep. Anything else that you would like to comment? Yes? No more? Dina? Dina Mardian? Dina Mardina? No? Are you there? Ahmad Rizky? Okay. If not, that's fine then. All right. Oh, yes, siapa nih? Silakan. Hello? Okay, Bu Nuraini, just show the next slide, please.
Okay.
Sambil nunggu slide yang muncul juga, you may still share what you have in your mind when you see the videos. Or maybe you can also pay attention to what are the differences when I speak in TED Talk and I speak here. Ada perbedaannya enggak?
The body language is, I think.
Who is speaking? Oh, Fadilah. Yes, Fadilah.
Yeah, when you speak on the TED Talk, you're pointing at the audiences, but when you speak on the camera, you're only waving and smiling, something like that.
Yes, yes, that's right. Because I cannot see the audience. I don't even know who the audience are, but the target is for international students who is planning to come to Wollongong or to study in University of Wollongong, or to new students who just come to Wollongong. And maybe Bu Aini, it can be part of your project, because this is one of the project in my speaking class for UPI. Mm-hmm. So I ask my students to think about to make this kind of video as well, because this is during pandemic. Thinking about what UPI students can do, do their weekend activities around UPI, which is close to UPI, not too far and not too so expensive, where they can go shopping, because the students are not all from Bandung. Many of them are from outside Bandung. So this can be a project to practice their public speaking as well. Yeah. All right. Next, please. Yeah.
Next. Wait.
Yes, next one.
Ish.
Now, yes, we come to nearly towards the end of our session. Yeah, I'm going to give you a chance to do the experiment with public speaking. I know some of you, many of you are shy to speak up here in this Google meeting. So I'm going to give you some privacy to practice. Okay, next slide, please.
Wait. Ish.
Yeah. Before I ask you to do the practice, let's have a look at this first. So when you start your presentation, as I told you that there's the beginning and then there's the ending as well. For today, I will just focus on the beginning and the ending a little bit. For the beginning, so there are the do's and the don'ts. Ada yang memang harus dilakukan, ada yang harus dihindari when you begin your presentation, no matter what, ya. Yeah? Now, for example, here, you read this and think about which one is the do's and the don'ts. But I think I would like to invite you again to read it for us. Yang yellow dulu nih. Siapa nih yang mau nih? Good morning. Thank you for having me on this beautiful day. I'm very delighted to be sharing with you all about public speaking. Terus kalau yang pink, today let me start by apologizing for presenting about public speaking. Actually, my lecturer, who is the expert, is here in this room, but I will try to do my best here. Okay, siapa nih yang mau coba baca biar enggak bukan saya aja yang ngomong. Ayo.
Rifanum, Miss.
Rifanum, yes. Please.
Yes, Miss. Good morning. Thank you for having me on this beautiful day. I'm very delighted to be sharing with you all about public speaking.
Excellent.
And then yes. The pink one, no, Miss?
Yes. Go ahead.
Today, let me start by apologizing for presenting about public speaking. Actually, my lecturer, who is the expert, is here in this room. But I will try to do my best here.
Oh, wow. Fluent. Thank you very much. Yes, I'd like to invite
welcome.
I'd like to invite others as well, please, to give it a try. Alpha Adnan, are you there? Just turn on the microphone and read. Sarif Hanum already gave us example. What? Yeah. Siapa ada boleh? Yeah, who's this? Who's speaking? Mawada, would you like to give it a try?
Yes. Yes, me.
Go ahead.
Good morning. Thank you for having me on this beautiful day. I'm very delighted to be sharing with you all about public speaking.
Yeah, next one.
Next one. Today, let me start by apologizing for presenting about public speaking. Actually, my lecturer who is the expert here is here in this room, but I will try to do my best here.
Good job. Thank you. Now, everyone, I would like you to chat, to type in the chat box again, which one that we need, that we are not supposed to do. The don't, which one? Is it the yellow or the pink? The don't. Write on the chat box, yellow or pink, the don't one. Nola finally already said, pink, 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 the pink one. No, I thought the pink one. Okay. Wow, everybody agrees, not the pink one. Okay. The pink, I guess. Okay. Now, thank you very much. Now, can I hear the reasons why? Why not the pink one? Who would like to share that with us? Yeah. Siapa? Kira-kira kenapa ya? Why not the pink one? Anyone, please go ahead.
Well, ma'am, may I?
Yes, Adila, go ahead.
Well, when I was in a class that my teacher say, when you do a public speaking, don't you ever say sorry or apologizing for your speech. So yeah, I guess that's why the pink was wrong one.
Yes, it's better not to. Don't start your presentation by apologizing. And that's why when I said, when I actually apologize because I don't know about Google Meet, that's so bad. I told you in the beginning, this is a bad example of how you start your presentation. But I learned my lesson, so the next thing that I need to improve is that I have to learn how to, I need to learn more about Google Meet, how to present, how to share my my PowerPoint more successfully next time, yeah? But yes, don't start your presentation with apologizing. For example, I'm sorry because I haven't read this chapter, I don't really understand. So there's no excuses. Yeah, you need to prepare, just like what Ibu Dian said. So you have to be prepared. If your teacher asks, because if you want to be a good public speaker, that you need to prepare everything. You need to be well prepared. But again, it's up to you what kind of aims that you want to achieve in your presentation. Yeah. Okay. Next.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So
sorry.
Okay. Let's just practice saying this. To wrap up, let's remind ourselves of why Flipgrid should matter to everyone here. Oh, the time is up. I still have one more point to talk about, but it's okay. I will give you my PowerPoint. Thank you. Nah, sekarang siapa yang mau coba to say this? The closing. Yeah, Utaf. Utaf home. Or anyone? Just turn on your microphone and speak up. Just read yellow and pink for the closing one.
Can I speak, miss?
Yes, of course. Yes, you are most welcome.
To wrap up, let's remind ourselves of why Flipgrid should matter to everyone here. And the pink one, oh, the time is up. I still have one more point to talk about. But it's okay, I will give you my PowerPoint. Thank you.
All right, good job. Yes. Next slide, please.
Wait.
Okay. Now, this is these are other examples how you can close your presentation. Yeah. To wrap up, let's remind ourselves of why this should matter to everyone here. So you've heard what I have to say. What conclusion can you take away from this? Let's say with me the main benefits of Flipgrid: efficiency, confidence, and fluency. Thank you. Okay, gimana kalau kita semua buka mikrofonnya and let's read the first one first. Okay, are you ready everyone? Please turn on your microphone. Everyone.
Ready.
Yes, ready.
Okay, on my count. Senangnya memang berjamaah ya. Kalau berjamaah pada seperti gitu ya, intonasinya. But actually, I really love to hear the Egyptian. Yes. Okay. Thank you. Next slide, Ibu Aini, please. Yeah. So we're going to do a little practice before we end our session. Yes, thank you. Now, if you are on your computer, I want you to go to Flipgrid. So you can enter the code 8V6B95BE. You go there, and then you will find PBI UIN by Ika Lestari Damayanti, and you can find the beginning. And it has instruction there, record yourself in opening a presentation. You may use script, tadi ya, boleh pilih yang mana yang ada, about Flipgrid, or you can make your own opening. And then, you just record a response. Udah ketemu belum Flipgrid-nya? Have you found it? If you have problems, or if you have found it, you can just type in the message. Oh, thank you, Budalia. Budalia already provided the code there in the chat box, so you can just copy that. Next slide, Bu Aini.
Okay.
Yes, and once you go to Flipgrid, you will be asked to join the discussion. So you can join with Google if you have Google email account, or you can join with Microsoft. That it will be easier. Next slide. Kasihan diminum. Saya minum juga. So you will see this kind of screen on your Flipgrid, and if you see, that's the red button with camera. That's where you can record yourself. So basically, you can just record yourself, and you may choose from the expressions that we have practiced earlier in that video, whether you the opening, even though I said the beginning, but you may choose. It can be opening or it can be the ending. But don't do the apologizing one. But the time is up one. Choose the good one, yeah? So is everyone good? Are you, can you find your way to Flipgrid? If you have problem, you may turn on your microphone and say to us, or you can just type in the chat box. Once you get there, please tell me. I still cannot see anyone yet. Bad connection. Okay, and let's see whether, but Asri, you can just pick one of the expressions, or you can just use your own if you like. Yeah, you can type here, or maybe I can ask you to do to practice again. I will invite you if you like. But I think it's just prepare first, just practice, and let's see. How about others? Please send me any emoji or anything to tell that you are okay, that you can get there. You can get to the grid. Bu Dahlia nyobain nggak masuk ke Flipgrid, nyampe nggak?
Nyampe udah.
Oh nyampe, alhamdulillah. nyampe, semoga tidak tersesat. Ada yang perlu diperlihatkan lagi bagian expressions-nya? Bisa go back ke. Okay, still loading. Okay, we will be waiting. That's okay. Still have time. Bu Nuraini, perhaps can you go back to the expressions, to the slide where show the expressions.
Which one?
No. The previous slides. Yes, go on.
Which one?
Before this, the beginning one. Yes, just this one. Yeah, let me check. I'm going to type this. Guys, can you report to me what is going on?
Still loading. Actually, it's running well here. I don't know what happened there with them.
In Sumedang, everything is good, yeah?
Yeah.
I'm going to share the expressions in the chat, so in case you need that, and also the wrapping. Yep. Any problem, guys? I give you another minute.
Anyone?
Lagi sibuk. Boleh di stop sharing dulu, Bu Aini.
Oke.
Okay. I'm going to share. No.
Tapi ini nutup semua, kayaknya lagi recording.
Yes. Still loading. Yep. Oh. What's going on? A Chrome tab. Yeah. Ya, ini tampilan Flipgrid-nya masih menunggu responses. Still nobody?
Come on. Kayaknya ada yang pakai eyeliner dulu gitu.
Ya, karena memang nggak bisa di turn off kameranya. Harus. Tapi Bu Aini boleh kalau mau nyobain Bu Aini.
Saya nyoba.
Yeah. Just give it a try.
Okay. Keep. Betulan nih harus ngeliatin ini.
Iya, aku benar-benar mau jilbab.
Oh well, I just get start with. Good morning. Thank you for having me on this beautiful day. I'm very delighted to be sharing with you all about public speaking. To wrap up, let's remind ourselves of why this should be mattered to everyone here. So you've heard what I have to say. What conclusions can you take away from this? Let's say with me, the main benefits of Flipgrid: efficiency, confidence, and fluency. Thank you.
Let's see if it is uploaded. Oh, we've got already 3 responses. Yeah. Funny, well done, Salma, Nola. Okay.
Good morning. Thank you for having me on this beautiful day.
Sure.
I'm very delighted to be sharing with you all.
Okay, let's see for Fanny Octavia, yeah?
Good morning. Thank you for having me on this beautiful day. I'm very delighted to be sharing with you all about public speaking. To wrap up, let's remind ourselves for why this should matter to everyone here. So you've heard what I have to say. What conclusion can you take away from this? Let's say with me during habits of Flipgrid, have efficiency, confidence, and fluency. Thank you.
Good job.
Yeah.
Good job. Well done, honey. Ini kalau ada door prize sebagai tulis. The first ini
online door prize.
Online door prize. Okay, let's see. Wah, oh, udah nambah nih ada OCT. Okay, let's see. Look at you! You smile, Salma.
Yeah.
You smile.
Yes.
Okay, so what's next? Man, masih nambah nggak nih kira-kira? Oh, masih 4 aja ya? Yang lain kemana? Dan kita lihat Nola nih. Let's see for Nola.
Good morning. Thank you for having me on this beautiful day. I'm very delighted to be sharing with you all about my public speaking. Wow, good job. Eye contact and smile too.
Well done. Yep. Okay. So everyone, Rizal, let's see Rizal, and then.
Good morning. Thank you for having me today. I'm very delighted to be sharing with you all about public speaking.
Good job, Rizal. Well done. karena baru pertama kali nyoba ya. Ini nanti bisa dibikin imut lagi, lucu lagi. Ini ada di tempat saya ada azan dulu di mute dulu aja. Sambil nunggu yang video-video berikutnya. Sambil nunggu azan juga.
وابعثه مقاما محمودا الذي
Okay, I think it's not adding up very significantly. Oh, but we have Rininta. Okay, let's see one more. And then let's wrap up.
Good morning. Thank you for having me on this beautiful day. I'm very delighted to be sharing with you all about public speaking.
Well done. Good. I like your smile. Well done, Rininta. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to stop sharing this. You may want still to continue practicing there in Flipgrid. You can always practice if you don't like with the way you look. For example, that you didn't make good eye contact, because in online settings you need to look at the camera, just like in face-to-face meeting. It's a bit like you're looking at your audience, but in an online, you need to look at the camera, yeah. But it's okay. You can do it in your time. You can always delete the video until you are happy with it. So you have your privacy time. If you think your voice is not really clear, don't forget to put three fingers on your mouth. Make sure that you produce loud and good quality of the voice. Yes. So Bu. Aini, could you please turn on my share slides again? Yes. Yeah, so actually we come to the end of our session, the presentation here. And I'm really happy that you have managed to speak up. I know that it's a bit challenging still to speak in front of public, like synchronous way where people are watching you and then you cannot repeat or you cannot edit your speech. But through Flipgrid, you can practice. You can always repeat. If you don't like it, you can redo it, yeah? And you can also evaluate. You can also make self-evaluation whether the quality is, the quality has reached with what you expected, yeah? Now, to wrap up, I would like you to write three words that you like from this presentation. Or you learn from this presentation. It can be about the principles, it can be about the preparation, related to the preparation that I talked about earlier, or is it about the beginning or the closing? What do you learn on that? Just write three words that you like from the presentation in the chat box now, yeah? Oh, ternyata juga akan ada group chat untuk Fani, Salma, and Nola. Wow, well done. Thank you, Ibu Kaprodi. Okay. Three words, guys. Anything that you can... three words that you gain from this presentation. Only three. Oh, if you have more words, please do. You're welcome. Write more. Yes. Sarikan, impressive, communicative, and motivated. Yes. The principle, topic, audience, and mode. Yes. Prepare to make yourself confident. Yes. Subject matter, spread positivity, getting the message across. Yes. Yeah, and of course, in public speaking, we might experience unexpected thing. Yeah, to keep ourselves interested in the topic that we are delivering and make sure that the audience interested as well. Fun, interesting, fun, motivated. We cannot undo what we said, and we should prepare well our speech. Yes, that's right. So preparation is very important. Yeah, motivate yourself. Yes. Right, interesting, fun, motivated. Okay, while you can go on continuing typing up those three words, if you have any questions, probably you may just ask. So that, yeah, okay. So
any questions?
Yeah, come on. If you have questions, please just turn on microphone. And if not, you can always...
Ma'am, actually, I got one question.
Yep. Who's speaking?
Fadila.
Fadila, okay. Yes, yes.
Well, since the start of the presentation of this Google meeting, I saw your picture on the TED Talk, and I went like, man, so amazing. And yeah, you know, at TED Talk, the biggest world public speaking facilities. And I was wondering, how do you feel when you're in TED Talk? And I was wondering how to be in TED Talk, because that's one of my dream too. Thank you.
Yes, I never expected to be invited in that event. But what I learned is because I always do the best in everything that I do. So because I always do the thing with passion. I love teaching. If I'm doing research, I will do the things that I love doing. Jadi nggak maksain karena harus mengerjakan apa. Kalaupun memang terpaksa harus mengerjakan sesuatu, I will find a way that those boring things can make me happy. Mm-hmm. I think from that kind of spirit, I always put effort in everything that I do. So as I mentioned earlier, I didn't expect to be invited in TED Talk, but it's because of my achievement, previous achievement, when I won the 3-minute thesis competition. So that was in my university in Wollongong. I have to compete with so many other students to win this competition. And then from UOW level, from university level, I went to the international level, and I won the People's Choice Award as well in that competition. But of course, it's not without any preparation. It took lots of time and effort for me to prepare my talk and then to rehearse. And before I prepare my talk, I also do some research on how people structure their presentation. Mm. And in TED Talk, as I mentioned earlier, so there will be like committee, something like that, in TED Talk, who will contact you and tell you the structure, what should you do. Like they, she told me that I would speak in around 8 minutes. So it means that I need to extend my speech from 3 minute thesis competition. So I'm thinking about in which part that I can stretch my presentation. And I'm also thinking about the audience. So whenever I do my presentation, I always think about the three things, the principles that I shared with you earlier, and then I make the preparation. Once I know the three things, topic, audience, and what kind of mode, what kind of stage that I'm going to be in, and then I start making the preparation, outlining, timing, and then think about how I can engage my audience and practice. Yeah. So I believe that you will get that chance too, as long as you put effort in anything that you do, and do not forget to always share with your community your experience in doing voluntary work. Sometimes, not sometimes, it always gives you more energy to do more, to give you more ideas, to do things in a better way. Yeah. Okay. Thank you, Fadila, for the question. Anything else?
I want to ask something, Miss.
Yes, Sabrina.
Okay. I have studied that there is statement, public speaking is just like acting. There is someone agree with this statement and don't agree with this statement. But for me, I don't need to be someone else to be able to speak well in public. But yeah, I just have to learn about technique like volume, gesture, tone, emotional, etc. And the important one is be the best of me. But I want to ask you, how about you, Miss?
Yes, of course, because it's hard to be somebody else. You need to be you. You need to be you, obviously. And perhaps I'm quite an outgoing person. It's okay for me to take risk. For example, in TED Talk, it was very, very scary, actually, when I had this idea in my head, I want to engage my audience because I have very limited time, but I have to convince them that storytelling is one of the best way to teach foreign language. So I have to think about the examples that make them, yes, so what you said is right, I agree with you. So I have to make their head nodded to what I say. So I have to think about, oh, they don't know Bahasa Indonesia. Bahasa Indonesia is foreign language to them. So I try to introduce some vocabulary in Bahasa Indonesia to them through storytelling. So at that time, and actually I cannot make different kind of voice when I was, for example, as crocodile or as kancil. I don't have the capacity, but if I learn more, probably I can. But it's just too much for me. So I just think about other way. It's better for me just to invite others and make my audience to be the sound, to be the voice of the crocodile or to be the voice of kancil. So you don't have to change yourself. Just you need to think a way of how to make your presentation interesting without changing your personality. But you can also always look up to the stars. It means that if you have your favorite public speaker, you can always observe them and imitate some of their ways. But of course, you cannot be them. You are a totally different person. But you can always look up to the strategies, to the technique that they use. So that's what I did as well when I prepare my 3-minute thesis presentation. I search in YouTube because there are lots and lots of example or videos showing the winner of the competition from several years ago. So I collected all the winners and I identified the pattern. What did they do? to make them win the competition. So that's how I learn. So yes, be yourself. And of course, you can always look to the stars and take some of the techniques that you think suitable to your personality as well. But don't be afraid to step out of step up out of your comfort zone, because you need to develop well if you are willing to take risks to get out of your comfort zone. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Miss.
Yes, thank you, Sabrina. Yes. Any more question or comment?
Yeah, maybe one question left.
Yes.
Well, Miss, mm-hmm. I was thinking about how you can be always motivated, because something like this. If someone had his first time coming to the stage and he has prepared all of his presentation very hard, and then the audience is just like, you're just boring, don't come on a stage like that.
Yeah, it's always scary to think about other people's opinion, but how to make yourself motivated? First, as I told you, you have to be willing to take a risk. And one of my principles, probably you have heard this as well. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Yeah. So that's what I typically that's what I do. Maybe Ibu Dian knows that as well, because we spend our youth together. I do care about other people's opinion, but there are times when I just want to see it. I want to give it a try. So if I do this, what is the response? What is the reaction? Okay, and it turned out with this bad. So, I don't have to go that way. I have to find other way. So it takes time to make me into who I am at the moment now. What you see now is more or less the polished one, because I've been through so many ups and downs of experiences. So I've been in one presentation, is in a workshop, and I was one of the participants at that time. And when I presented, I thought that I have prepared and I have done my best, but then I got very, very bad review from the trainer. And actually, I really wanted to cry at that time, but I have to hold my tears back because lots of people there and lots of other people also got that kind of feedback. It was not only me, but of course there are some others who got very, very good feedback and evaluation. So that kind of moment, I don't want to make that kind of moment to make me stop from doing the things that I like. But I learned, okay, at that time, what was the feedback? Of course, at the time I heard the feedback, I will deny everything. No, you just don't know what I'm talking about. You just don't know me and things like that. But I will just let the anger out, and then I take time, I took note, and I try to think about the feedback that they gave me. And also once I got feedback, very bad feedback as well, from the one that I look up to, because that person was one of my stars, and I inspired by this person. But then one day, this person gave me very bad comment, something like, oh, your English sounds like Ethan. Your English is Ethan English, because I'm very Sundanese. I have very strong Sundanese accent, even though I don't know whether I'm Sundanese or not, but I was born here. So that kind of thing made me feel down, upset as well. But it doesn't stop me from doing what I'm doing now. And then it turned out that I just need to fix. So it means that I need to be aware more of my voice tone and my pronunciation, things like that. But later on, I also learned about that actually I can imitate British accents or American accents. But as adult, I have my conscious choice. But maybe I don't want to be sounds like Harry Potter. Maybe I just want to be sounds like Ethan. I want to sound like this. So this is me. But again, I just try to don't think too much about negative comments from others, but if I think that those negative comments can build up my competency, I will take that in and I will get the bad feelings about it. It's not easy, but it is doable. Yeah.
I think
yes.
Three questions enough. We got it.
All right. Yeah, 2 minutes before 12. So thank you very much for having me. I'm really enjoying this, and I hope you gain lots of things from this presentation. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you for the very presentation. I just amazed and then don't know what to say to wrap up all of this webinar. Since I don't know, so many things inspired us a lot as well, maybe as well as all of the students here also. Thank you so much. And then the thing that I want to retell here, because it is very important and it is very impressed me a lot, is from your word, is put a great effort on your work and then do it with love.
Yeah.
Which is it is very have to keep in on our students' mind, I mean, maybe students' mind, that you have to put a great effort in every your assignments and every all of your performance and as well as everything, and then try to enjoy every single a pass of your work and then of your life. Thank you so much again to Bu Ika, and then jangan kapok kalau nanti ada follow up dari ini atau kita akan mengundang lagi Bu Ika ya buka produk.
Ya. Insyaallah.
Jangan kapok Bu Ika ya.
Ya.
Dikontak mendadak lagi.
Terima kasih udah stay awesome within 3 hours here. Oh my god. Thank you so much.
That's
great. Yeah, 3 hours very good job. Dengan suara yang masih still 3 hours, gak ada turunnya. Oh, how come? Ini makanya kale terus kayaknya. Yeah, thank you so much Bu Ika, and then thank you so much also for all the audiences here, untuk semua dosen-dosen di lingkungan PB UIN, juga Ibu Kaprodi, juga Bapak Kajur dan Sekjur, juga all beloved students here that you have participated here. Thank you so much. And then I think the last, thank you so much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. See you.
Assalamualaikum. Thank you Bu Miss Aini. Mohon surveinya di sini ya.
Ibu Ika, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Ada survei serta linknya ada di chat. Mohon diisi ya.
Ya.
Miss Aini,
ya Bu,
boleh dimatikan sharing screen-nya.
Oh iya iya.
Sorry. Nah, Bu Ika-nya sudah keluar. Ya, mau minta.
Yang tadi ada, Bu. Tadi nanti saya share.
Mau minta email Bu Ika. Mau minta email Bu Ika.
Oh iya, nanti chat. Nanti di chat.
Untuk share ini hasil surveinya.
Ya,
saya dimintain.
Sama mau bilang, Bu, my classmate say hi.
Telat dong harusnya tadi.
Iya. Tadi mau nulis.
Udah ini. Lapar dan haus. Kasih.
Iya, kasihan.
Betul.
Tadi. Tadi mau lapar.
Sekarang coba ditolong di-share dulu cheesecake-nya. Cheesecake Bunda Lia. Terima kasih untuk semua mahasiswa.
Terima kasih, Miss Aini.
Ibu, terima kasih.
See you soon. Moderator
terpanjang ya.
Masuk muri.
Masuk murid. Oke, tenang, nanti Bu Predari masih ke hari Sabtu ya. Yang ada waktu hari Sabtu, ini masih ada yang stay ya?
Lebih panjang sih, lebih panjang ya, yang kemarin.
Ya, hari Sabtu masih ada Pak Gumawang Jati. Itu akan, tapi arah ke semester 5, semester 7 sih yang sedang TPL. Gitu ya. Ibu Dian, thank you.
Sama.
Ini mah kayak reuni ya, mudah-mudahan kawan-kawan dapat manfaatnya. Bu Dahlia, thank you. Sudah buatkan link.
Ketemu nanti ya. Assalamualaikum.
Salam. Ya. Ibu Dian, ditunggu. Bu Aini, ditunggu.
Bu, makasih.
Makasih, Miss.
Makasih, Bu. Saya lift.
Ayo, yo.